I hate being
Please disperse!
There's nothing to see here. Go back to your homes.
Keep your head up.
That's fine.
I see Tannis's hair from here.
Is she... Her, she, I, and Ari are doing a rap group together.
It's fucking badass. We'll do it one day. We'll keep talking about it.
Well, we showed up here, two of us really sick, not knowing that we were going to have to play two sets, so we're not going to play as long of a set as we did earlier. Thanks for coming. We have a new record downstairs. It's for sale finally. This is the first song off it. It's called Kill Traitors.
Yeah.
you. Oh, what happened here? It'd be dangerous. Put your snakes away, boys. You guys are thinking. Our friend Rich brought his snake in here, by the way. He's got it with him. So if you're afraid of snakes...
How long is it?
It's pretty fucking big. It eats live mice. Catches them right out of the air. So if you're in this area, or maybe it's over there. No, it's somewhere.
Fuck you! Fuck you!
51% of our tax dollars on the military, while New York City has 91,000 kids that don't have desks. They're meeting in like auditoriums and such with their books and their notebooks in their laps, because that's where the priority is. Security means making sure that nobody who, you know, it's not like somebody like Saddam's gonna come over here and fuck with us. I mean, the top 6 or 7 countries that we're most likely to go to war with, we spend 18 times more than all those countries combined. Okay, in certain parts of this country, there's conditions are comparable to the way it is in countries, places like Bangladesh and other third world parts that we look down upon. We need to reprioritize. We need to realize that certain things like corporate welfare, last year something like $170 billion, all these free handouts, get people starving on the street, and yet these people who make, people like Mike Eisner of Disney making $102,000 an hour last year, and you have people out there who are never going to see that kind of money in their lifetime. Saddam's got a big dick too, apparently. This is a new one, it's called You Wanna Play Cards. And this is to give them a round of applause, because I know that you guys are here to check them out. We're very honored that they wanted us to play with them on this show. Actually, both of these shows. So this is for these guys. This is another one for the new record. It's called Sabbath. We'll be right back.
Let's go.
Thanks a lot, guys. Lifetime's up. You guys zip it already. Anyway, this is our last show. This is our last show. Alright, again, we have to go over the lights in our rider. Yes, red only.
Perfect! Don't touch it! Recondition them!
Anyway, this is the first song off of our newest record. It's called Turnpike Gates. I'm not afraid to die.
we're supposed to do something there. Hey, we need everybody to back up a little. This is kind of that. But be nice when you're backing up. If everybody agrees to back up, then everybody will back up, right? Can everybody hear everything out there? Yeah? More vocals? More vocals? Is that possible? Come on, Mickey.
I know you can do it.
All right, ready, everybody, push. Swatter.
Okay, you're all. Get them to move back.
Hey, how they all push?
That's better. That's better. I'm all move fuck back. I'm all move fuck back.
If you don't like me,
I'm all hit them back in the
ass. No, you don't.
All right, irony.
Finally, in my pants.
How we are, okay, that's what we'll do now. How we are. I'll hold the mic for you, Dave.
Where's my 50 cents?
50 cents? Anyway, this song's called How We Are. Well, come over here. Don't stand in the corner.
Yeah!
Yeah! Good singer!
Saves the day, everybody!
Whoa! Yeah. Hey, Chris saves the day! You know the lyrics? Okay. Sure.
I know!
The kids.
Participated. This is a song that Petey wrote. If you will. Yeah. some room again. Move back a little, please.
Ow, that's my nipple! Ari, you're so tough!
I'm so tough?
You're a tough guy!
Yeah, I sure am.
I just want to tell you really briefly one of the reasons why I love Pete, because 10 years ago, me and him were the only like hardcore kids that each other knew, and we would go to City Gardens together, and if one of us had to work, we'd have to go alone, and it was cool.
Oh, yeah? I guess so.
And we'd be like at an AF show, and we'd be the only people in the whole place with hair, and we'd be scared shitless, like crying behind the bar.
That's what happens when you're from Westfield, you know what I mean?
I'd like to say something. The first time I saw this band was just a few blocks away at St. Peter's High School. And maybe one or two were there. And this is the last time I will see them. And in between the time, thanks to Dan, Ari, Dave, Pete, Scott, and Dave Ayushis, who's not here tonight, I got to go across this country once, go to Europe twice, and got to hear a lot of beautiful music. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Wilkie. Hooray for us! This song's called Francine Owen. It's on the new record. It's I don't know if any of you guys know it. Yeah, when we wrote it, we never thought we'd have to play because it's kind of hard to play.
It's really hard.
Must be tough being a rock star.
Yeah, it must be tough being ugly, you know what I mean? This song's called Francie Nolan. It goes out to me, I guess. I don't know who else it would go to.
Ego!
Backwards. Yeah! is for suckers. Takes off their clothes.
Yeah.
guys really gotta back up.
Oh man.
Or as I like to say, back the fuck up. What? Someone's bleeding? That's what I like to see, some blood. You guys gotta really take it easy.
I'm not calling you!
Who lost the X-Men hat? You? What did it look like? Does it look like the one David's wearing? You know the laws.
Huh? I just felt the need to say at this point, hey, chill out.
No, chill out.
Chill out. Chill out. God, fucking relax. It's a fun time. Have some fucking lemonade or something. Nobody, there better be not anybody staring at each other with their fucking eyebrows down. Like, what? What? It's not the place for that shit. And the other thing is, I hope that you guys who live locally appreciate the fact that Endeavor is from New Jersey, because they're like a fucking steamroller, man. They kick so much ass and they're amazing. Thanks.
This is a song about the, this is a song about being in a van for lots of months. Alright,
See? No room. Fireball!
There we go.
Alright.
2 seconds. How the fuck are you gonna have like three goddamn people on this column? That's enough, there's two. We'll be right back.
He has Dan Yemin.
He's got us like awesome.
Turn on some lights.
Hey,
hey.
Boys, no good.
Hey, Dan, what's your mask?
Boys, no good.
Yeah. You say, Dan, what's your mask?
Max.
Max. Max?
What's your mask?
Well, this week he's carbo loading. And, I don't know what that means, but he's doing something. He's doing something right. I mean, look at him.
Beefcake!
Dr. Evil!
This is a song off our first 7-inch. You'll be excited when you hear us play it. Because I don't know the words, really. So if anybody knows them, you can help me out. Okay. This song's called Dwell. Back seat.
Thanks. Go ahead and take it.
Okay.
Nah, I ain't gonna be able to make it up there anymore.
So it's called the gym.
But well, since I have some time, I just want to thank everybody responsible for putting the show on. It's been quite an event. And, well, I guess it depends on where you're standing. I think it's going famously. It's going real smart. But I want to thank Chris Ross because even though he's old as hell, he's still able to get up every day and do something like this. And so, hey, good one. You're gonna mess up my hair. That's true. Don't fuck yourself. But anyway, I want to thank the Melody and everybody who's here tonight, and all the bunch of knuckleheads that helped out downstairs and stuff, and all the bands that played and all that kind of stuff. It's probably the first time I ever thanked that many people in my life.
What song?
Marriage.
Hey, what time is it anyway? Does anybody know?
It's 9 o'clock!
What time is it? 8:45? Alright, we got 15 minutes. Alright, this song is called Somewhere That Swaps the Jersey. If anybody knows, where I got that line. What's that? Alright, you get something. That was exciting, wasn't it? Anyway, somewhere in the swamps of Jersey.
You are the
A string because we broke it. A string. Or a bass. Can somebody back there pass us up a bass? All right, a quick intermission and then a few more and then...
Is that thing muted?
Yeah. So, let me think of a story, I guess.
So,
Everybody's heard my Civ dream, right? Civ? Oh, yeah. Has anybody heard my Civ dream?
We do that one in Philly.
All right, so I won't do that one.
John Voight,
no, I don't want to do that one. That's a little complicated.
I'm in the bath, the ladies' room.
Tell us about Dave Gomes.
Dave Gomes.
Anybody want to hear a Civ story? All right, this is just to kill time, of course. I had a dream one time, and I know some of you have heard this. I break into the shtick when we had nothing to do. But anyway, I had a dream that me and Dave here were eating in a diner, and then Civ comes in with his like whole gang, his whole crew. Like the whole band, you know? Like all these fancy ladies and they're all dressed up real fancy like. And they sit in the booth next to us, and then Civ comes over to me, and he's like, you know, starts talking to me, but then he starts talking shit. So we get up and me and Civ start fighting. And I like, I beat the crap out of Civ. I'm like, hold on, it's not over. That's better. So, what's that? Must have been a dream, man. He's like a 90-pound weakling. So anyway, I beat him up, right? I beat him up, and then, you know, his whole crew sees that, you know, I just beat the crap out of Civ, so they try to come after us. So me and Dave, like, run down the street, and we're running down the alley, and then it turns into, like, this Rancid video, and it's all slow motion, and they're in all these, like, old, like, Lincolns and shit, and they're, like, chasing us, and they run Dave over and kill him, and then, and then I make it to this, like, busy street, and I, like, flag down this lady, it's this, like, old woman, and, she pulls over and I get in the car and then she starts like pulling out my wiener and jerking me off, I guess. And then I woke up.
Did you come or what?
I didn't come, no. Anyway, you know, I didn't want to have to do that to you.
What are we doing?
Peace, Harry! Truth about Lars. Okay, we got two more songs to do for you.
New England!
Boys no good!
Boys no good, truth about Lars. I'm gonna go get some.
a good night.
One more!
Do we have time for one more, Ross? Alright, let's go do one more. The song's called Verona Kings. Anyway,
yeah!
Again, just thank you very much for making this a good experience and just making Lifetime worthwhile. And,
we love you!
Just thanks a lot. It means a lot to all of us. And I personally want to just thank everybody in the band for the last like 8 or 9 years of my life. So, I'm talking
group hug!
It's been a while. I don't know. I'm getting old. Anyway, this song's called Verona Kings.
I'm gonna
Thank you very much. Thanks for singing along all the time and all these years. Take care.
That was awesome.
Stand.